guys doing today? Long time no see, right? Today, yeah, I'm gonna be reading a really famous short story called The Most Dangerous Game by Richard Connell. And yeah, let's just get right into it. Oh, hope you guys can see that. I don't know if it'll come out on the screen, but yeah, if you can follow along, that'd be cool. Off there, to the right, somewhere is a large island, said Whitney. It's rather a mystery. What island is it? Rainsford asked. The old charts call it Ship Trap Island, Whitney replied. A suggestive name, isn't it? Sailors have a curious dread of the blues. Sorry about that. I don't know why. Some stupid superstition. Can't see it, remarked Rainsford, trying to peer through the dark. To the dink. So, I rather think they understand one thing. Fear. The fear of pain and the fear of death. Nonsense, laughed Rainsford. This hot weather is making you soft, Whitney. Be a realist. The world is made up of two classes. The hunt. Has a reputation, a bad one. Cannibals, suggested Rainsford. Hardly. Even cannibals wouldn't live in such a godforsaken place. But it's gotten into the sailor lore somehow. Didn't you notice that the crew's nerves seemed a bit jumpy today? Thank you. and tried to cry out. was a chance that his cries could be heard by someone aboard the yacht, but that chance was slender and grew more slender. As the yacht raced on, he wrestled himself out of his clothes and shouted with all his power. The lights of the yacht became faint and ever vanishing. Thank you.
His hand
advanced to Rainsford and held out his hand. In a cultivated voice marked by a slight accent that gave it added precision and deliberateness, he said, too, were black and very bright. He had high cheekbones, a sharp-cut nose, a spare, dark face, the face of a man used to giving orders, the face of an aristocrat. Turning to the giant in a uniform, the general made a sign. Pistol, saluted, withdrew. Ivan is an incredibly strong fellow, remarked the general, but he has the misfortune to be deaf and dumb. A simple fellow, but I'm afraid, like all his race, a bit of a savage. Is he Russian? He is a Cossack, said the general, and his smile showed red lips and pointed teeth. So am I. The bedroom with a canopied bed, big enough for six men, that Rainsford followed the silent giant. Ivan laid out an evening suit, and Rainsford, as he put it on, noticed that it came from a London tailor, who ordinarily cut and sewed for none below the rank of dining room always thought, said Rainsford, that the Cape buffalo is the most dangerous of all big game. For a moment, the general did not reply. He was smiling his curious red-lipped smile. Then he said slowly, Mr. Rainsford. The general took from his pocket a gold cigarette case and offered his guest a long black cigarette with a silver tip. It was perfumed and gave off a smell like incense. "We will have some sensation. May I pour another glass of port?" "Thank you, General." The general filled both glasses and said, "God makes some men poets, some he makes kings, some made for the trigger," my father said. "He was a very rich man with a quarter of a million acres in the Crimea, and he was an ardent sportsman. When I was only 5 years old, he gave me a little gun, specially made for me to shoot sparrows with. Alexian, Paris. Naturally, I continued to hunt. Oh my god. Grizzlies and Iraqis, crocodiles and Akinjis, rhinoceroses in East Africa. It was in East Africa. It was in Africa that the king buffalo ate me and laid me up for 6 months. As soon as I recovered, I started for the Amazon to hunt jaguars, for I had heard they were unusually cunning. They weren't. The Cossack side, they were no match at all for a hunter with his wits about him and a high-powered rifle. I was bitterly disappointed. I was lying in my tent, beginning to, with a splitting headache one night when a terrible thought pushed its way into my mind. Hunting was on. So, said Rainsford. The general smiled. I had no wish to go to pieces, he said. I must do something. Now mine is an analytical mind, Mr. Rainsford. Doubtless that is why I enjoy the problems of the chase. So, continued the general, I asked myself why the hunt no longer fascinated me. You are much younger than I am, Mr. Rainsford, and have not hunted as much. But perhaps you can guess the answer. What was it? Simply this. Hunting had ceased to be what you call a sporting proposition. It had become too easy. I always got my quarry. Always. There is no greater bore than perfection. The general lit a fresh cigarette. No animal had a chance with me anymore. That is no boast. It is a mathematical certainty. The animal had nothing but his legs and his instinct. Instinct is no match for reason. When I thought of this, it was a tragic moment for me, I can tell you. Rainsford leaned across the table, absorbed in what his host was saying. Came to me as an inspiration, what I must do, the general went on, and that was, the general smiled, the quiet smile of the one who has faced an obstacle and surmounted it with success. supplies me with the most exciting hunting in the world. No other hunting compares with it for an instant. Every day I hunt, and I never grow bored now, for I have a quarry with which I can match my wits. Rainsford's bewilderment showed in his face. I wanted the ideal animal to hunt, explained the general. So I said, what are the attributes of an ideal quarry? And the answer was, of course, it must have courage. And above all, it must be able to reason. But no animal can reason, objected. One that can. But you can't mean, gasped Rainsford. And why not? I can't believe you are serious, General Zzzaroff. This is a grisly joke. Okay, guys, I think I'm going to end it right there. Thank you guys for staying with me. If you have watched until this point, hopefully it was a good choice.